Is culture in decline in the city?
It could be because of the economics, you
Yes.
know. When the economics goes a little awry, I suppose these things happen because the arts need strong sort of patronage.
Yes.
And I think, you know, what my husband keeps saying, because he studies these things, he's an economist,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, when we tend to despair and we say, how is it? So he says that, but it's cyclical also, you know,
mm-hmm.
because Calcutta was the first place to industrialize, you
yes.
know, before other parts of India, Calcutta and its hinterland.
Yes.
It is only natural that, you know, cyclically, the decline of the industrial age is also, you know, it's part of, it's in many European cities, that is the sort of cycle too. So I think what we need is to reinvent ourselves in the things that we are good at, you know, so education,
yes.
you know, I think, that, and a lot of is already happening, I believe, in the sciences also. There are these cutting-edge institutes, some fabulous work has been done in biomedical stuff. And so perhaps that's the way to go. So you have culture, and you have the education sort of, you know, which I think has begun with presidency, because I think what presidency is going to do now is it's going to attract great students from the rest of the country. So so there's always a thing that we are losing. There's a massive brain sort of a brain drain. Young people are leaving in large numbers.
Yes.
Both to other parts of India and abroad.
They're leaving and they're doing very well, because, I mean, it's not that there's a lack of talent, it's quite the opposite.
It's quite the opposite.
There's a lack of opportunity.
Yes. So I think that is, while that is always going to be there, if we should think about attracting
yes.
People, you know, attracting young people.
Mm-hmm.
So I think if, so the education system is one way of, you know, doing it.
Mm-hmm.
With the colleges and
speaking of education, you studied English,
yeah,
right, and
yeah.
then Natya Shastra, and I know that many consider you know, the study of dance or the dance as
yeah.
as an art form to be a really high form of art because of the integration of music. Of you know,
of drama and dance.
Exactly.
So Natya is both
yes.
both dance
and
drama.
Yes.
So it's sort of a very fluid concept,
mm-hmm.
which is why it fits in very beautifully with the idea of performance studies as opposed to theater studies. You
yes.
know. So when performance studies developed in the West, they looked at India and Japan and
mm-hmm.
you know and China to see that traditionally it's never been sort of theater divorced from the other art forms.
Mm-hmm.
It's always been a kind of a holistic thing, which is why we also have our Bollywood films the way they
yes,
are.
Yes.
They're all musicals, and so it's very kind of full circle.
It's like
you
a
know?
Contemporization of the classical dance drama, right?
Yeah. And also drama. So the Natya Shastra, you see, it's an encyclopedia. You know, it's
mm-hmm.
in 36 chapters, and it's a massive text. It has everything. So it has the rules of drama. It has very extensive notes on how actors and female actors should behave.
Mm-hmm.
On dramatists and playwrights, and it also has stuff on the theory of drama.
Mm-hmm.
So how does meaning emerge? Which is where, you know, it advances the rasa theory.
Right.
So it's a fascinating text. Thank you, Shidai.
Thank you very much, and thank all of you.
Purusham.